Now let's take some example of vector product. Suppose a force F equal to 4 Newton acting in on a an irregular solid, and this irregular solid is pinned or nailed in a point O. This irregular solid is nailed at a point O, and this vector is acting at a distance of three meter from O, and this vector is denoted by vector R, since this is a displacement vector. Now if we find R cross F, it will result torque, and torque is a vector quantity. So vector R cross F will be vector R, magnitude of R, magnitude of F, and angle between the two vectors. Now my data or information is insufficient, so I need the angle between R and F. To get the angle between R and F, I have to shift F here parallelly here. And here I find that this is equal to 30 degrees, suppose. This is equal to 30 degrees. Okay. So therefore, my R cross F, the value of my R cross F, that is the magnitude, is R is 3, F is 4, and sine 30 degree. That is 3 into 4 into 1 by 2. That is 6, and unit is going to be Newton meter. But this is the magnitude only. And torque is a vector quantity. So in which direction this torque will act? So your R is here and your F is here. So you have to move your arm from R to F, and it will act upward. So we have to make it a vector, we have to multiply it with a unit vector. And the direction of unit vector is perpendicular. What is n cap? Unit vector perpendicular to both R and F, perpendicular to both R and F, and acting outward. So this way we find vector products, where you will be given two vectors and angle between the two vectors, and you have to find the vector products, and the quantity what you obtained must be a vector quantity. Earlier when I posted the video of a scalar product, there we also found work done, but and we multiplied there also displacement vector into force, but there we need, or in our question it was asked to find the work done. Work done being a scalar quantity, we performed their scalar product, and here we supposed to find torque, and torque being a vector quantity, we need to find vector product or cross product, and this way we find the cross product of any two vectors resulting another vector. We perform a product operation and the result is also a vector quantity, and this way we obtained vector product.